Yes.
Okay, great, all right. Oh, they do?
Yeah.
Oh. I didn't see them. Okay, great. You guys are 2 steps ahead. So, how many of you, this is your first year? This is going to be easier for you than it is for everybody else. I want to explain that. So, a lot of people, you know, had a hard time getting the maritime language down, and you know, they're still adjusting to it. Totally acceptable, and understandable. So, if you think about it, throughout the regular Camp Fitch summer, they have 7 to 8 weeks of camper sessions going on. So, you know, we have one every year. It took them about 2 seasons to really just get great at it. So, you know, if you convert it, that's like, well, I don't know, 16 years, but, you know, I think we can do a little better. But, so y'all have a maritime translator in here. Really, the most important differences are the fleet names. Many of you are used to having 2 different names for the villages, for boys and girls. The biggest transition there is that boys and girls are both sloop fleet. There's schooner fleet, there's clipper fleet, and Zulu fleet. So each one of those, the kind of story behind those is that they represent a type of a sailing ship. A sloop sailboat is just a one sail, one mast boat, and it's the smaller of all 4 of them. The only exception there is the Zulu, combat ship, but you know. So next we have the CITs, and they kind of have 2 names. So they're Perry's fleet, named after Commodore Perry. Commodore Perry is it's a great leadership story that occurred on Lake Erie. It's got a lot of roots in Lake Erie lore. And then individually we call them midshipmen. They're kind of in between, you know, so they're in between being a camper and transitioning to become staff. Galley crew, they're the dish crew. They're probably the easiest to identify because they will readily identify themselves as galley crew, whether you ask them to or not. Campers are crewmates or shipmates, or just mates for short. Counselors, you guys. Skippers or captains. Skippers is pretty much the colloquial term, so that's what we use most commonly. Everybody at Camp Fitch will call you a skipper. That's what they're used to. So, you know, that should make that a little easier for you. All of us, we are admirals or commodores. If you call us directors, that's fine. If you call each other counselors by accident or, you know, just habit, that's fine too. Try and use the language, but don't be discouraged if you miss an opportunity to. I would say try the hardest in front of the kids and in front of the parents. Because they're the ones who really have to know, okay, I'm in sloop fleet, or I'm at the hook. The people, the villages of people are now fleets. And the locations where they stay are harbors. And we made it pretty easy with the transition for the names of the harbors because they're really just a piece of the former name. So where Inca Hook is now the hook, Aztec Alley is the landing, that one's a little bit different. Cherokee Square is the square. Sioux Line is the line. Strawny Cove is the cove, and Apache Point is just the point. So where we used to have tribe time, we call those voyages now. And then kivas, we call those ropes, as in learning the ropes. So a lot of those things are related to their actions. So, you know, for instance, with ropes, you're learning the ropes. I wish I had some secret sauce to tell you how to get these down, but to be perfectly honest, I still don't have 100%. You know, I'm at camp about every weekend, at the very least I'm there every other weekend, and constantly using these phrases, and I find myself all the time saying director or Inca Village, you know, and then pictures do too. So, you know, it's not like it's a rule written in stone. It's just a thematic framework that we're trying to apply. So, but I really don't have a secret sauce except for just try and use it, you know, try and practice it. That's really, I think, what will help out the most is just use it even if you don't have to. Okay, so you all have this map. By and large, you're probably pretty familiar with it, but camp is always changing. In fact, this map is mostly up to date. Well, it's the most up to date one we have. Just a few things on the map. You want to be aware of the meeting areas. Russell Lodge is the main bathroom for girls' camp. Kristen Lodge is the main bathroom for boys' camp. The individual fleets or harbors. Their name, their old names here might be a good exercise if you scratch them out, put in the right names. For what it's worth. Some off-limits areas like Glen Oak Lodge, that's down the hill, and no real reason to go there. The dining hall is an important place. From what I understand, there's going to be a tour Saturday, right? Saturday? Everybody?
Hope everyone comes at what time?
9 a.m.
Oh my gosh. 9 a.m. Saturday, meet me there.
Are you bringing cupcakes?
Next Saturday.
No, I don't like cupcakes.
Next Saturday. Well, actually, you can come this Saturday if you want to build the beds.
Alright.
So, last year we did a pizza mixer. This year we're going to do a burger hot dog mixer down by the beach with a nice campfire and everything. So, Fitch is invited, and I think it's going to be a lot of fun. Yeah, so this is still. So, last year we did a pizza mixer, and this year we're going to do hot dogs and hamburgers. Good question. Where are you supposed to park? You should come up the hill and park in front of Myrto Lodge. It's a blue house-looking lodge that is near a baseball diamond. You'll see cars parked there already. And then once you guys get moved into your vets, we'll have a caravan that will take you and your cars to their final resting place. Girls can park in front of Russell.
Okay.
Or just cars.
I'm looking at waking up in an hour and like stuff.
What's that? So one note about parking near Russell. So don't park on the grass that is on the side of the road that the cabins are on. We're trying to grow grass there.
Got it.
So I have your Quebec assignments, your tentative Quebec assignments. Especially in girls' camp, these are particularly subject to change. Because girls are just difficult. On these sheets, they have a new system this year called Camp Minder. So all the campers, they go and sign up on this electronic form, and they can upload all their stuff. And one of the cool things is they can upload a picture of the camper. The one catch there is that the Quebec numbers aren't finalized in there for our organization. So on these assignments, just look at the campers that are in your Quebec. Don't worry about the camp or Quebec number. All right.
All right. So another thing I got.
running really well on time, so those of you that were like, hey, I don't want to be here until 9 o'clock, you know, we're on track. I want to, before we move into the next section, I want to kind of let you know where we're at. This turned out to be a very difficult staff year as far as getting guide counselors. Okay, so we technically, as it stands right now, based on the number of campers we have, we could use two more guide counselors. Okay, so what our plan is right now is going with what I call a hybrid director counselor. So that means a director, two directors will be taking the event as well. It's doable, it's not ideal. Okay, so at this point, if you know, and some of you have mentioned, maybe there are some other people that are interested, if you know somebody that might be interested, I need to know, because we're kind of in that 11th hour now that we're reporting to Kent in a week. So I want to make decisions by tomorrow. So if you know somebody, I'm going to give you a phone number and they need to contact me tomorrow. Because after tomorrow, I think we kind of have to finalize staff. Trying to bring in new staff with less than 7 days just seems crazy. And the other good thing is you can see we're recording this training. We did that on purpose so that if something like that happened, we could put, they could still be subject to the material we covered tonight. They could watch it. So if you know somebody and you want to talk to me after, not right now, that's fine too. But if you want to pass my info on to somebody and you think you know someone that's interested, come get my cell phone from me so that they can just contact me on that. That'll be the quickest way. Okay? So we're looking for two. So if you know anybody that would be good, please pass them along. It'll make all of our week a little bit smoother.
Well,
we have to
stay away from everybody.
All right, so next, Megan is going to take over here, and we're going to do a little bit of song work. And we are nearing the end of our evening, so bear with us.
Come up with a song from this packet, and then if you're a CIT